Okay, welcome to solve this equation, but we're not going to square both sides because if you do that on the right hand side with that x2 for a force power term, right? So that's so good, that's bad, that's dangerous. In fact, that's a trap. So here's the idea. We see we have 5 minus x inside the square root and it's 5 minus x squared. And here's the idea. Hopefully, you guys have seen my video on the infinite nasty Michael Jordans because that's how we're going to do it. Right here, I'll move this to the other side, move this to here. You will see why. This is going to be x squared that's equal to 5 minus that square root of 5 minus x. And of course, I can just take the square root on both sides. Of course, don't forget the plus minus, and we can cancel this out. And in fact, this equation, it does have two solutions, because if you graph this right here, you get this, and if you graph this, you get that, and of course you see two intersections, so it has two solutions. That's why you have to really consider the plus minus. So let me just write this down right here. X is equal to the positive version of the square root of the 5 minus the square root of the 5 minus x. And then on the other hand, let me just write down x is equal to the negative version of the square root of the 5 minus the square root of 5 minus x, like this. And now I will just write this down again in red, though. So we get x is equal to square root of 5 minus the square root of 5 minus x. Why do I want to do that? Because right here, you see here we have this x. I can put this down right here for this x. So you see, x is actually nothing but just the square root of the 5 minus the square root of the 5 minus x, because x is now that, so I can plug in. So it's minus that square root of 5 minus square root of 5 minus x. X is what? I can just plug in this into itself, right? So we have the minus square root of 5 and so on, so on, so on. So I can just put on dot, dot, dot like this. And hopefully you guys don't mind. Well, right here, I will use a purple pen, because now I see this part is nothing but just this x by purple. So if you would like, you can actually write this down as follows. This is just x equals to square root of 5 minus this purple x. This is really cool, isn't it? And now we can, of course, continue. We can square both sides. So we get x squared. And of course, let's move this and that to another side. We get plus x minus 5. And this is equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. It has two solutions, but I just care about the positive version because right here, x is positive, right? So care about the positive version. And of course, use the quadratic formula. X is equal to, of course, do the negative b, which is negative 1. And then you just add square root of b squared, which is 1 squared, and then minus 4 times this times that, you get 20, and then you pretty much do 1 plus 20, you get 21 right here, all over 2 times that, which is 2 times 1, which is just 2. And this is the first answer right here. And now let's check this out. This is really cool. Well, of course I'll do the same thing. I will just put down x is equal to negative version of the square root of 5 minus the square root of 5 minus x, like this. Of course, you see here we have this x again. I will put this down right here for that. So we see that x is nothing but just the following. This is negative square root of 5 minus square root of 5 minus, well, this x is negative, so minus minus, of course, this becomes plus. And then, of course, you have the square root of 5 minus the square root of 5 minus, right? But x is negative, so in fact, this becomes plus. And then, of course, you can just pretty much have this, and so on, so on, so on. And in fact, this is like alternating term of the infinite nested radical. Really cool. But how do we do this? Well, of course, let's use the purple pen again, right here. Let's just focus on this part right here. So I will make a note on the side for you guys. This is how we can do it. Whenever you have an infinite nested radical, if it alternates, just like this, suppose you have a, and then minus square root of a, plus square root of a, minus square root of a, and so on, like this. In fact, you have a really, really nice formula, this right here. You can just write it down as square root of 4a minus 3 minus 1 all over 2, like this. And of course, I'll probably prove this to you guys on the other time, for the other time, but like in here, a is just 5. So you see, this x is just equal to negative, and all this is just by this formula now. So you can just plug in 5 for the a, and of course, 4 times 5 is 20, minus that is 17, instead of the square root, so you have square root of 17 minus 1 all over 2, like this. And that's for this part, right? And of course, if you want to be cute, because we are cute, so I can distribute the negative. So in fact, in the end, we get, let's put on the negative 1 first. Negative, negative 1, which is positive 1, and then negative 17, instead of the square root, and all over 2, like this. And with that, we're done.